I have explained many, many times a control scan. Now I'm going to show it to you. This is an important update. This goes for all users, for all equipment. Over here, I have an untouched test field. I'm going to show you exactly what I mean when it says do the control scan. For much easier data, better analysis, better recognition, and more success. I'm walking over here to this test field. This is a perfect example. You can see with my footprints in the snow exactly where I'm walking. In this example, I'm going to choose our ground scan. I'm going to do automatic. Parallel is the method I recommend. Once I'm ready to start, I'm going to set myself up. I'm looking at my target and I want to make sure I'm straight. Okay, don't tilt, don't twist, don't turn. And then I start. I'm walking at the same speed, and I am creating a target here in the distance. I come to the end, I stop. Now I'm going to return back to do round two. Using the 5500, I have that much more of a scan area. Keeping your speed is very important. Okay, scan one is finished. I'm going to save it. 5 meters forward, 4 meters wide, scan is saved. I've done one scan. I am going to go back and do the exact same scan again. Come back to my start point, and I'm going to do the exact same scan again. Because I want to see the consistency. Now, when you're working a larger field, and if you happen to be working in the snow, it can't get any better than having your footprints already in front of you. Because this way you see exactly which path you are on. You know exactly where you were stepping. And plus you can see every one of your footsteps. Okay, so now I have two scans. I want to save those scans, giving the exact same dimensions. Now comes the third scan. Now I'm going to go exactly 90 degrees to the first two. Because if my target is in the scan, I want to see it once, twice, and then I want to go 90 degrees to it and see it again. To walk straight, look in the distance. Thank you. Okay, so now I have done my three scans. Let me save this file. When I take the two scans and put them right next to each other, the results will be the same or similar. You'll see, in this direction I have a hit, in this direction I have a hit, and in this direction I have a hit. You'll put all three of the scans together and show you how we're going to break down our scan analysis. All right, so we finished doing the scans outside, and now I'm coming into my EXP5500, and I've got my screen here saying File Explorer. I'm going to go ahead and touch that up here. Now I want to transfer the data from that. It's just extremely simple. What I'm going to do here is go ahead and plug in my USB cable, and then to the USB-C here. There we go. I'm going to click on the file transfer mode. In the PC, automatically starts up here. Go in here and take my scans from today. So, 1, 2, 3 today. I'm going to copy these off. I'm going to create a new directory, and this directory is going to be control scan. Okay. And this is where I want to save the data to. Copy and paste. I can go into my Visualizer 3D, open up my scans, and see what I have. The control scans, as mentioned before, are critical. They have to match. With the EXP5500, this new unit here, you have your little thumbnails. So, okay, and with the thumbnails, you can quickly identify this without having to transfer the data over when it's a very clear scan object. Otherwise, then you can go ahead and transfer the data over, open everything up in the Visualizer 3D Studio. The main thing that I'm doing here is ensuring that our scans are correct and the same and repeatable. Repeatability is the entire factor. How do I find something that's buried? I want to know how to find it. How do I find it? How do I know that it's there? As I look here in my windows, you're going to see I'm going to arrange side by side. I have three scans. My purpose of repeating the scan is to try to duplicate it. When I see the same scan coming over, and I see it over here, and I see it over here, since it's underground, we don't walk exactly 100% perfect. We're going to have slight variations. But as you see here, scan number one, I have the object here in the right-hand side. Scan number two, I have the object here in the right-hand side. Scan number three, I did 90 degrees to the first two. So I'm going to take that scan, and right now I can just do it visually, turn it 90 degrees, and it's in exactly the same place. I can repeat it. I see it in the unit. I see it in the Visualizer 3D Studio. That's a control scan.